What have we here?
Boiler. This dredge character's meddling will be the death of us. He was loitering around the exchange today, asking far too many questions about the bank. Should he discover my plan, you will face a far worse fate than losing your job. Signed, Plutus.
So this Plutus is Starek's banker, hmm? I wager Dredge will lead me to him.
While you're out and about, do attempt not to destroy modern medicine or the London transportation network.
Don't make me laugh.
Innocent lives hang in the balance. They depend on this city.
I'm not the one who let Lucy Thorne walk away.
A mistake I intend to rectify immediately.
This is going to go bad for you. Confess, and you'll save us all some grief.
I didn't do nothing. So help me, Bob! Miss Evie, we kept buying drinks. The next thing I know, they say I burnt someone.
Oh, Nigel.
I had one too many and lost all my things. They must be scattered all about. Oh, and there's a knife out there too. Could you get them before the Rozzers do?
Shut up!
But that's way too far!
Someone's made it into here!
Just come out, it'll go easier on you.
She's here!
I could swear by the Almighty there was something right here.
Do you see her?
Find a hat that fits him. That's a death warrant.
The chief inspector is due any second.
Chief Inspector will be here soon.
don't want to hurt her. Whoever you are. I'll get her. I'm after
her. She looks like trouble.
I have a clear shot at her.
Just your imagination.
Under arrest. She's not getting away.
No, you're there. You're a fool if you think you can defeat me.
Is that the best you can do?
Not good.
Keep up.
I have a clear shot.
Yes. I know you're hiding somewhere.
Oh, yes.
Thank you.
What? Sleeping in an haystack, are you?
Strange lady.
Come out and join us for a drink.
Closer,
I'm warning
you.
That's not suspicious at all.
What's the rush, you maniac?
And what evidence are you holding this man?
Why, on, Sergeant?
I believe at a minimum you need a body.
We can't find a thing, Inspector.
You botched another one, Sergeant.
How nice to see you again, Mr. Dickens. Is it time for another of the Ghost Club stories?
As a matter of fact, yes. Follow me. Number 50, Berkeley Square. Four stories high and branded, Beware All Those Who Enter. There have been many strange tales of this dreadful domicile. The earliest report of a haunting was said to be the specter of a small girl who was murdered by a servant. She could be seen at the attic windows, weeping and wringing her little hands in an agony of despair. You're not afraid, are you? Another legend claims the attic is haunted by the spirit of a young woman who purportedly threw herself from the top floor windows to escape her abusive uncle. Her screaming ghost has reportedly been sighted hanging from the window ledge. This residence was briefly owned by a Mr. James Jasper, a choir master and an opium addict. His nephew, Edward, was betrothed to one of Mr. Jasper's pupils, the fair and delicate Rose. However, Edward disappeared under mysterious circumstances, followed by Jasper himself. Perhaps grief sent him back to the soothing arms of his narcotic mistress.
Here now. Easy now. Come on.
Shall we? Though this house is vacant, some say it comes alive at night with screams of terror, ringing bells, and slamming shutters. Although eerie, this phenomenon is easily produced by pneumatic tubes and valves. There are claims that a young man was caged in the attic, his only connection to the rest of the world, a tiny hole in the door. A young man who was reduced to madness by this extreme isolation. The legends all seem to focus on one room in particular. Yeah. a sudden draft. Nothing more. My word. Perhaps I shall wait here while you investigate the source of that laughter, which is not at all unsettling.
The sound of that.
Let me go, you moke!
Charming. Right. Now tell me, why were you at that?
I've found a lock, but I haven't located the key.
It's here.
So this is how it works.
Impressive.
Get out of my house!
Stand back, Charles.
Good Lord. There was no one whose love for Rosa came near to equaling mine. It should have been enough to keep my beloved nephew away. My poor Ned. Forgive.
Alas, the myth has been discredited. There was no ghost in Berkeley Square, just a wretched soul driven to murder and madness by guilt and intoxication. I think this is the makings of a rather fine novel. I wonder if I've got one left in me.
Huh?
fight better. Not very much.
I just cannot tell you how very grateful I am. No respect for other people. I hope I just cannot tell you.
We're off to Covent Garden in the morning.
There's been a spate of rather intriguing thefts about town recently.
Robberies in London are hardly supernatural events.
Could she?
What's that man done?
Robbed the pawnbrokers down the road.
A demon made me do it. I can't remember much. That's what's so queer. I've never stolen anything in my life before.
Let's pretend that I believe you. Tell me who made you do it.
All I can recall is a...
Ugh. What can you tell me about the robbery?
There's not much to say. Most of the items did come from the same seller, Enzio Capelli, Sorcerer Supreme, a famous showman from Italy. Several weeks ago, he was forced to pawn his family heirlooms, debts. I have the address of the last person who redeemed something of his, a lovely pearl necklace. That helpful?
Not again! Stop her! Stop! Somebody stop that thief!
You took something from a pawn shop.
It's all very
something easy, is going on.
I remember something silver flashing in my eye.
My only lead is this mysterious fire. This chap might lead me to the demon.
To give me the necklace now, don't you?
Yes, I want to give you the necklace now.
Ooh.
Mr. Enzio Capelli, I presume? So you're responsible for the theft of your own jewels?
You are very much mistaken, aren't you, my child?
Yes, I'm very much mistaken. Hold on.
You are very much mistaken. And now you are so very, very tired, aren't you?
Yes, I'm very, very tired.
Now, you're going to do a little job of work for me, aren't you?
My goodness,
What foul behavior.
What's going on? Where am I?
You've been arrested for theft. How very intriguing.
I can't remember a jot of it.
Let's get you out of here. I've pulled a few strings, and they won't prosecute on account of your losing your mind. Be free, little chicken.
Versi color, commonly known.
I didn't know you had a twin sister, Mr. Fry.
Evie Fry, sir. It's a pleasure.
Usually I would reciprocate the sentiment, Miss Fry. But today, I'm afraid nothing will bring me pleasure.
What's troubling you, sir?
I am used to people challenging my ideas. In fact, I live for it, the cut and thrust of spirited debate. Lately, however, attacks against my reputation have taken a darker turn. Threats of violence against my person and against my colleagues. I do not wish anyone to be hurt because of my research.
You help me with steric syrup. I am in your debt.
We help each other, sir.
My brother and I will make sure that you can continue your work in peace.
What do you know of bones?
Only a few of their names learned from books.
Perhaps it would be simpler if I just explained the situation.
Wouldn't hurt to know what the bugger looks like.
Yes, I should stay clear of.
Wouldn't hurt to know what the bugger. What's a German do- What's a German? Wouldn't hurt to know what the bugger looks like. Wouldn't hurt to know. To look like anyway. Would hurt to know what the bugger looks like.
Must I involve myself in your life?
How am I going to find him among all these people?
Wouldn't hurt to know. What's a German doctor supposed to look like, anyway? Wouldn't hurt.
Mr. Darwin has sent me to ensure you reach him safely, with your cargo intact. Just act naturally.
Right. So, how is your father? By which I mean my dear brother Frank, with whom I grew up, of course. Oh, splendid! Wonderful to hear! I'll do my best not to call attention to how remiss he was in forgetting to warn me about the delicate situation which brings me here today.
Dr. Schwartz?
Never got on the train.
Thank you.
you do anything you'll regret. I should deliver this to Mr. Darwin.
Last. My heart hasn't stopped pounding. You have it? Wonderful. But where is Dr. Schwartz?
I'm afraid he was intercepted, sir, in Germany. However, I have recovered the fossil.
Dear Lord, I should tell you, I was recently approached by men who sought to purchase all my research on the condition I work only for them. Obviously, I refused. Scientific knowledge cannot be bought,
It belongs to everyone. Let these villains do their worst.